Hello, good morning. Yes, good afternoon. Another lecture of BOT 353, that is Intellectual Property Right. This is Professor Srikant Karnevar. Today, we will go to the tour of Switzerland. You know Switzerland, where it is Switzerland? I will take you to the Switzerland. Switzerland, which is located here. This is our North America, this is South America, and this one is India. And head office of this World Trade Organization, which is located here in the Switzerland. In previous lecture, we learned about GATT, that is General Agreement on Trade and Tariff. After GATT, WTO was established. Here, this is, you may see, this is a head office of World Trade Organization, which is located at Geneva, Switzerland. Just take a history of this WTO. In previous lecture, we discussed about GATT. That means GATT was established in the year 1948, its actual working, and it was winded up in the year 1994. At the end of this GATT, it was concluded to establish an organization that should be accepted by most of the countries, and whatever the lacunas which were in the GATT, that were overcome by this WTO. WTO was established in the year 1995, and on the same year India became a member of WTO. Similarly, India was also a member of GATT since 8 July 1948. Now let us try to understand what is WTO, what is World Trade Organization, and how India is become benefiting from this WTO. So this is a place where the member country comes and talks together and share their grievances in order to resolve their problem related to international trade. Say for example, one company which is located in Korea, and that company is willing to trade in India. So that is possible, and it is channelized by this WTO. The countries make their decision through various councils and committees whose membership consists of all WTO members. If there is any dispute occurs while trading for getting more profit or more benefit, some obviously there may be a chances of disputes, and that disputes are handled or solved by this World Trade Organization. How it solves, so we will see in the next few slides. Now, what is absolute advantage for any of the member countries? Say for example, Japan, it produces automobile products and these are worldwide accepted. And India is a producer of agriculture and textile product. On one way, Japan can export their cars or vehicles to India, and simultaneously India can export their agriculture produce to Japan. So how it is get benefited, since export is taking place, and obviously the farmers or the traders will get more benefit by exporting. India became member of WTO in the year 1990. Afterwards, India has benefited hugely from its participation in the system. It helped India to more than double its share of global exports in goods and services, and it creates new jobs and reduces the poverty. Therefore, there is a key role of WTO for all the member countries to channelize or to promote their export. You may take another example. Say, for example, in United States of America, if there is a bank and that bank is willing to establish its branch in India or in some other countries, it may be possible due to this WTO system. Similarly, it is the same with the case of insurance, telecommunications. Already we know that head office of the Vodafone, which is located in Italy, and from that Italy, so that company is working in several countries. That trading, it is possible only by the WTO. Similar to that, hotel chains and another export companies. Now we will see what is meant by WTO and how it works. So there are, of course, number of ways of looking at the world organization. It is organization for what? For trade, to do the business in different countries. So it is a forum for government to negotiate the trade agreements. Say, for example, in taluka level, so there is a presence of APMC, that is Agriculture Producing Market Committee. So that committee is responsible to do the trade within a taluka or within a district. But this WTO, due to the establishment of this WTO, anyone can trade freely in anywhere in the world. So that's why this WTO, it is a place for them to settle their trade disputes. Also, it operates system of trade rules, essentially the WTO, where member governments try to sort out these problems whenever they face at the time of trading. WTO agreements, it is signed by the bulk of the world trading nations. There are several nations. At present, there are 164 member nations who have signed this agreement. As we discussed earlier, that WTO was created on 1st January 1995. It marked the biggest reform of international trade since the end of Second World War. So initially GATT was there, definitely GATT was there, but due to some lacunas, GATT could not be succeeded. That's why at the end of this GATT, that means in the last round of the GATT, that is Uruguay round, so GATT led to the development of WTO. This is one of the youngest international organization, that is the successor of the GATT. Firstly, GATT has came, and afterwards this WTO came into existence. Here it has specific procedure so that it can settle the disputes which occurred at the time of trading. In brief, what we can say that the WTO is the only international organization. It is dealing with the global rules of the trades. Main functions is to ensure that trade flows smoothly as freely as possible. In 1997, 40 governments successfully concluded the negotiation for the trade tariff, free trade in information technology products. 70 members concluded financial services dealing with the covering more than 95% trade in banking, insurance, securities and financial and information. That means you can clearly imagine that after the existence of this WTO, now world came into a one channel. If it is related with the information technology, if it is related with the banking, anyone can freely trade with any of the countries, because the WTO which governs the rules for these kinds of trades. In 2000, WTO started in agriculture and services. So why this WTO started this agriculture and services, because agriculture was not a part of GATT, and due to one of these reason GATT was failed. So to improve the lacunas of GATT, WTO started on agriculture. So these were incorporated into broader work program. The new work program included negotiation and the other work or no agriculture tariffs, trade and environment. WTO rules also on anti-dumping subsidies, trade facilitation, transparency in the government, intellectual property, all these things were not handled by GATT agreement. Again, in the year 2011, again WTO expanded the coverage of their area. That means due to the due to which it agreed a 100 billion transaction. Here you may see that, so these things, that is agriculture and textile, these things were excluded by GATT. But due to this WTO agreement, free trade can be possible of this agriculture and as well as this textiles. That's why it increased the trade between different countries. Another reformation of this WTO, that here you may see this IT products. So these IT products, initially they were too costly. So due to this WTO agreement, so the prices of this information technology products, due to the eliminated tariffs on these IT products, again this become more cheaper and these are now available worldwide. So it was around 1.3 trillion per year. Formation of this WTO is that WTO enters into the intellectual property agreements in the year 2017. So that's why, as it enters into intellectual property agreement, another reformation is that the medicine, the cost of medicine, which was earlier very high, it was not affordable to the common peoples, maybe in some developing countries. But due to this WTO agreement, so these medicines, most of the one of the important agreement of this WTO, which was taken place in the year 2017. So due to that, so accessible, affordable medicines now can be available at a cheaper rate in various developing countries. Now let us look at the structure of WTO, how it works. WTO has 164 members, accounting 98% of the world trade. So this is controlled by the WTO. Now let us look at how it governs. First of all, there is a governing council body, below which there is intellectual property. Here is the structure of this WTO. Here at the top, that there is a ministerial conference. Below that, there is dispute settlement body. It resolves the disputes. Trade policy, it take a review after each year, and they reforms the policy. Another most important part of this WTO, that is General Council, that is also known as GC. So this GC is again working under work for these four important parts, that is Trade and Development, Goods Council, Intellectual Property and Service Councils. So all these are the councils which gives complete reformation of this WTO, and it channelizes the world trade and the smoothening of world trade. So if you look at the specific activities of this WTO are, of course, negotiating the reduction or elimination of the obstacles of the trade. Let's say, for example, tariffs, other barriers, agreeing the rules on governing the conduct of international trade. For example, to give the subsidies, anti-dumping and product standards, administrating and monitoring the application of WTO, the rules for trades in goods, trades in services, trade-related intellectual property rights, all this comes under this WTO. This WTO reviews the trade policy after each year, and they provides a transparent system for taking the review and formation of the new rules. It also works for settling of the disputes regarding the interpretation and application of the agreement, whether all the agreements were followed by each member countries or not. It gives capacity building training to the government officials of member countries. If suppose few of the three, there are 30 countries, these are still not a member of this WTO. They just assist the process of accession of 30 countries to become a member of this WTO. They conduct research, economic research, collecting and dissemination of the data, and explaining to and educating the public about the WTO. These are the... This was all about WTO. In the next lecture, we will discuss about TRIPS. Before that, just overlook what is difference between GATT and WTO. Thanks for watching this video clip. See you soon.